Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Good morning, students. Now we are discussing applications of derivatives, miscellaneous exercise. Up to question number 10 we discussed. Next question, question number 11. A window is in form of a rectangle surmounted by a semicircle opening. Means my window is like this, ma. Okay, now this rectangle, on top of that there is a semicircle. Okay, window is in form of a rectangle surmounted by a semicircle. Okay, semicircle opening. The perimeter of window is 10 meter. Perimeter of window is 10 meter. Okay, perimeter of window is 10 meter. Find dimensions of window to admit maximum light through the whole opening. Okay, have to find dimensions of the window to admit maximum light through the whole opening. Okay, so maximum light is possible when area is maximum. Maximum light is possible when area of the window is maximum, means will maximize area. Will maximize area. Okay, will maximize area. A window is of this form, a rectangle, on top of that a semicircle. Okay, window is in this form, rectangle shape, on top of that there is a semicircle form. Okay, now here this is semicircle, rough diagram. Now let radius r be the radius. Okay, r be the radius of semicircle. Okay, now this is radius r, means this is also radius r. So length is equal to how much? Length of the rectangle is 2r. Length of the rectangle is 2r. Length of the rectangle is 2r. Okay, now let breadth is x. Okay, other side is x. Okay, so one side of rectangle is 2r, other side is x. So what is given? Given in the problem, perimeter of window is 10 meters. Perimeter means length of the boundary. Perimeter is nothing but length of the boundary. But this is x, 2r, x, and perimeter of semicircle. Perimeter of semicircle is how much? Pi r. Perimeter of semicircle is pi r. So what is perimeter now? Total perimeter of this window is x plus x, 2x plus 2r plus pi r. This 2r won't be there, ma. This 2r won't be there. Okay, perimeter means boundary, length of the boundary. Okay, so how much it is? Perimeter is x plus 2r plus x plus pi r. Okay, nothing but 2x plus 2r plus pi r is equal to 10. Okay, so perimeter P is equal to 2r plus 2x plus pi r is equal to 10. Sorry. So what we have? 2r plus 2x plus pi r is equal to 10. Okay, from here what we can write? I'll keep 2x this side and remaining terms this side. So what we get? 2x is equal to 10 minus of pi r plus 2r. So 2x equal to 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. 2x equal to 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. So x is equal to what we'll get? X is equal to 1 by 2 into 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r, we can add. Okay, anyhow 2x will keep it as this. Now 2x is equal to 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. I'll mark this one as 1. Okay, now Here question is find dimensions of window to admit maximum light through the whole opening. Okay, maximum light is possible when area of the window is maximum. Okay, so let A be the area. Okay, let A be the area of the figure. Then area is equal to what? Area is nothing but area of this rectangle plus area of this semicircle. Okay, so area A is equal to area of semicircle plus area of rectangle. Area of semicircle plus area of rectangle. Now area of semicircle, semicircle area is how much? Half of circle area pi r square by 2. Okay, so area of semicircle is pi r square by 2 plus area of rectangle is length into breadth. No, length into breadth. So length is how much? 2r. Breadth is how much? X. So 2r into x. 2r into x, what we can write? R into 2x we can write. No, r into 2x. So r into 2x from 1, 2x what we can write? 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. So area is equal to pi r square by 2 plus r into 2x. 2x is 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. Okay, area is equal to pi r square by 2. This is area of semicircle plus area of rectangular part is r into 2x. 2x is nothing but 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. Okay, if you simplify, if you multiply r inside, so what we get? 10r minus pi r square minus 2r square. Okay, so area is equal to pi r square by 2 plus 10r minus pi r square minus 2r square. Okay, if you simplify, A is equal to 10r. Now half pi r square minus pi r square, half pi r square minus pi r square is minus pi r square by 2. Okay, so if we take LCM of these 2, no, so 2 pi r square minus 2 pi r square is minus pi r square. So nothing but minus pi r square by 2 minus 2 r square. So area is equal to 10 r minus pi r square by 2 minus 2 r square. Now here changing quantities are r and x. Okay, we wrote everything in terms of r. Okay, area function in terms of r we wrote. Now differentiate with respect to r. Differentiate with respect to r. So what we get? dA by dr is equal to 10r derivative 10 minus 1 by 2 into pi into 1 by pi by 2 into r square derivative 2r. No, so minus pi by 2 into 2r, 2 to cancel, minus pi r, minus pi r. Okay, minus 2 into r square derivative 2r. No, so minus 2 into 2, minus 4r, minus 4r. So dA by dr is equal to 10 minus pi r minus 4r. Okay, dA by dr is equal to 10 minus pi r minus 4r. Okay, mark this one as 2. Mark this one as 2. Okay, now second derivative, d square a by dr square. D square a upon dr square is equal to constant 10 derivative 0 minus pi r derivative minus pi minus 4r derivative minus 4. Okay, d square a by dr square is equal to minus pi minus 4. Minus pi minus 4. Okay. Now for minimum or maximum, for minimum or maximum, put first derivative equal to 0. Put first derivative equal to 0. That is dA by dr equal to 0. Okay. For minimum or maximum, dA by dr equal to 0. So dA by dr equal to 0. dA by dr equal to 0. So dA by dr equal to 0 means from 2, this part equal to 0. No? Nothing but 10 minus of pi plus 4 into r equal to 0. So if you write this term this side, so what we get? 10 is equal to pi plus 4 into r. So r is equal to how much we get? R is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4. R is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4. R is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4. R is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4. Okay. Now at r is equal to pi upon 10 upon pi plus 4, if you verify sine of second derivative. Sin of second derivative. What is second derivative? Second derivative d square a by dr square is equal to minus pi minus 4. This is a constant function. There is no r term at all. There is no r term at all to substitute. This is a constant function. How much it is? Minus of pi plus 4 or minus pi minus 4, which is a negative. Which is negative. Now second derivative negative at a point where first derivative is zero. So by second derivative test, by second derivative test, r is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4 is point of maxima. By second derivative test, r is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4 is point of maxima. Point of maxima. So r is equal to pi upon 10 plus 4. This is nothing but radius of semicircle. No? So radius of semicircle r is equal to what? 10 upon pi plus 4. 10 upon pi plus 4. So radius of semicircle we got. Now length and breadth of rectangular part are what? 2r and x. 2r and x. We have to find what is 2r and what is x. Okay. Now one side of rectangle is 2r. 2r is nothing but multiply this quantity with 2. So what we get? 2r is equal to 20 by pi plus 4. 20 by pi plus 4. Okay. 20 upon pi plus 4. Now another side of rectangle. Another side of rectangle is what? X. Okay. So x is equal to how much from 1? X is equal to from 1. X is equal to how much? 1 by 2 into 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. X is equal to 1 by 2 into 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. Okay. So x is equal to 1 by 2 into 10 minus of pi plus 2 into what is r? 10 upon pi plus r, no? 10 upon pi plus 10 upon pi plus 4, sorry. R is 10 upon pi plus 4. Now take LCM. LCM is what? Pi plus 4. So x is equal to 1 by 2 into denominator pi plus 4. If you write pi plus 4 here, 10 into pi plus 4 minus pi plus 2 into 10. Nothing but what we get? 10 pi plus 40 minus 10 pi minus 20 upon pi plus 4. 10 pi minus 10 pi cancel. 40 minus 20 is 20. 20 upon pi plus 4 into 2. 2 cancel. So x is equal to what we get? 10 upon pi plus 4. Okay. Now here what we have? X is equal to? X is equal to 1 by 2 into 10 minus pi plus 2 into r, where r is 10 upon pi plus 4. Okay. Now if you take LCM, LCM is what? Pi plus 4. Okay. So what we get? 1 by 2 into 10 into pi plus 4. 10 into pi plus 4 is 10 pi plus 40. If you multiply minus here, minus 10 pi minus 20 upon pi plus 4. Okay. Now 10 pi cancel. 40 minus 20. 20 upon pi plus 4 into 2. 2 2 also cancel. Ma. X is equal to how much? 10 upon pi plus 4. X is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4. Okay. Ma, light is maximum. Area is maximum. No? So length of the window what we have to take? 2r is equal to 20 upon pi plus 4, and breadth of the window is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4. Okay, these are the dimensions of window, so that maximum light through the whole opening. Okay, I'll repeat once again. Here question is, a window is in form of rectangle, okay, on top of that a semicircle. Okay, perimeter of window is given as 10 meters, and we have to find dimensions of window which admit maximum light through the whole opening. Okay. Now let r be the radius of semicircle. Okay. So one side of rectangle is 2r and other side is x. Okay. What is given? Perimeter is equal to 10 meter. Perimeter formula. Perimeter means length of the boundary. 2r plus x plus x 2x. 2r plus 2x plus pi r is equal to 10. So from here 2x equal to 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. Okay, mark this one as 1. Okay. Now maximum light passing through the window is possible when area is maximum. Okay, area of semicircle plus area of rectangle. My required area equal to area of semicircle plus area of rectangle. So a is equal to pi r square by 2 plus area of rectangle is length into breadth 2r into x. Okay, so pi r square by 2 plus r into 2x. What is 2x? 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. Okay. So what we get? Area is equal to pi r square by 2 plus 10r minus pi r square minus 2r square. So a is equal to 10r minus pi r square by 2 minus 2r square. Now here a is in terms of r. So for minimum or maximum, find first derivative and equate to 0. So differentiate with respect to r. So what we get? dA by dr is equal to 10 r derivative 10 minus 1 by 2 into pi r square derivative is 2 r, r square derivative 2 r, 2 to cancel, minus pi r minus 2 into r square derivative 2 r, nothing but minus 4 r. Second derivative d square a by dr square is minus pi minus 4. Okay. Now for minimum r maximum put first derivative equal to 0. So after simplification what we get, r is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4. So at r is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4, second derivative is negative. So second derivative negative means by second derivative test, we have point of maxima at r is equal to pi, 10 upon pi plus 4. R is maximum, point of maxima is r is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4. Okay. So radius of semicircle is how much? 10 upon pi plus 4, and one side of rectangle is what? 2 r, no? 2 r is nothing but 20 upon pi plus 4 and x. Okay. Other side of rectangle is what, ma? X. So from 1, x is equal to what we can write? 1 by 2 into 10 minus of pi plus 2 into r. Okay. Now what is x, ma? X is equal to 1 by 2 into 10 minus of pi plus 2 into what is r? 10 upon pi plus 4, by substituting r value 10 upon pi plus 4. Okay. So what we get after simplification, x is equal to 10 upon pi plus 4. So light is maximum and area is maximum. So dimensions of rectangle has to be length is equal to 2 r, that is 20 upon pi plus 4, and breadth is equal to what? X, that is 10 upon pi plus 4. Okay. Question number 13. Find the points at which the function f of x equal to x minus 2 power 4 into x plus 1 power 3 has local maxima, second one local minima, and point of inflection. Okay. But local maximum exists when derivative changes from positive to negative about a point. Okay. Now what we have to do is we have to find f dash of x. Okay. Now around a point, if derivative changes from positive to negative, at that point maxima exists. Okay. If f dash of x is changes sign from negative to positive, at that point minima exists. If f dash of x does not changes its sign throughout about that point, it is a point of inflection. It is a point of inflection. It will be like this, ma. Now here derivative positive, here derivative negative, means derivative changes from positive to negative about a point, maxima exists. Okay. If derivative changes from negative to positive about a point, minima exists. Okay. If derivative does not changes its sign throughout the point, it is a point of inflection. Okay. Now what is given question? Given function f of x equal to x minus 2 power 4 into x plus 1 power 3. Okay, differentiate with respect to x. So what we get, f of x derivative f dash of x equal to, ma, here UV rule, ma, we'll apply UV rule. Okay, first function into x minus 2 power 4 into x plus 1 cube derivative, x power n derivative, n into x power n minus 1, no? So x plus 1 cube derivative 3 into x plus 1 square. Okay, plus x plus 1 derivative 1 only, ma. So plus second time x plus 1 cube as it is, x minus 2 power 4 derivative 4 into x minus 2 power 3. Okay, 4 into x minus 2 power 3. Okay, into x plus 1 cube as it is. Now from these two terms we can take x minus 2 cube common as well as x plus 1 square common. By taking x minus 2 cube into x plus 1 square, so what else we get here? 3. And x plus 1 square common and x minus 2 cube common. So still we have x minus 2 here. So 3 into x minus 2 plus 4 into my x minus 2 power 3 common, no? Okay. So x plus 1 cube here we have. We took x plus 1 square. So still we have x plus 1. So x plus 1. Okay. So f dash of x equal to what we have, x minus 2 cube into x plus 1 square into, if we simplify this bracket, 3x plus 4x, 7x minus 6 plus 4 minus 2, okay, 7x minus 2. So what we have, f dash of x equal to x minus 2 power 3 x plus 1 square into 7x minus 2. Okay. Now for minimum or maximum, we will put f dash of x equal to 0. So f dash of x equal to 0, so what we get, x minus 2 power 3 into x plus 1 power 2, 7x minus 2 equal to 0. So x is equal to what we get? X is equal to 2 minus 1 and 2 by 7. Okay, x equal to 2 minus 1 and 2 by 7. Okay, now these are the critical points. Now we'll check the sign of f dash of x. Okay, around 2, around minus 1 and around 2 by 7. What is it meaning is how f dash of x changes around 2 means just below 2 whether f dash of x is positive, just above 2 whether f dash of x is negative, like that. Okay, okay. Now at 2 what is f dash of x is x minus 2 power 3 into x plus 1 square into 7x minus 2, no? Okay, now if you consider just below 2 x slightly below 2, x less than 2, just below 2 if you take any number, okay, for example 1.9, for example I am telling, okay, 1.9 for example. Now 1.9 minus 2 is what? Negative power 3 is negative, this is negative. Okay, now because of square it is positive, whatever you substitute, positive, negative, whatever you substitute, this is positive always. So this is positive, and x you consider as 1.9. So 1.9 into 2, 1.9 into 7, minus 2 is obviously positive, no? So negative, positive, positive, product is what? Negative. Okay, product of this negative, positive is negative. Okay, so f dash of x below 2, just below 2, it is negative. Now f dash of x just above 2, okay, so for example if you consider x as 2.000001, okay, so 2 point something minus 2 is positive, positive cube is positive, this is positive, this is also positive, 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 positive is positive. So f dash of x changes sign from negative to positive, f dash of x changes sign from negative to positive around a point, at that point minima exists. Okay, so x equal to 2 is point of local minima, x equal to 2 is point of local minima, x equal to 2 is point of local minima. Okay, now next one, at x is equal to minus 1, at x is equal to, what are the critical points here? 2, minus 1 and 2 by 7, no? So at 2 we verified, now at minus 1, okay, but just below minus 1 and just above minus 1 we'll check. Okay, so just below minus 1 is negative, no? So negative minus negative is negative, negative cube is negative, so this is negative, but because of square it is always positive, negative, positive, now this is negative, so negative, positive, negative, overall it is positive. Okay, just above minus 1 consider it as just above minus 1. Okay, so just above minus 1 minus 2 is what? Negative. Negative power is what? Negative power odd is negative. Okay, now because of square it is always positive. Okay, this is negative, so negative, positive, negative, overall it is positive. So here f dash of x does not change the sign around x is equal to minus 1. Okay, does not change a sign around x equal to minus 1. So x equal to minus 1 is point of inflection. X equal to minus 1 is point of inflection. Around a point, if sign changes, okay, around a point, if f dash of x changes from positive to negative, at that point maxima exists. That is point of local maxima. Okay, if f dash of x changes sign from negative to positive around a point, that point is point of local minima. Okay, if f dash of x does not change its sign about a point, that is point of inflection. Okay, so at x is equal to 2 by 7, next point is at x equal to 2 by 7, so f dash of x just below 2 by 7, but just below 2 by 7, 2 by 7 below, this is negative, this is positive and this is negative. So negative, positive, negative is positive. Okay, next, just above 2 by 7, this is positive, this is positive, but this is negative, so overall product is what? Negative. So around 2 by 7 f dash of x changes its sign from positive to negative, from positive to negative.
So x equal to 2/7 is point of maxima. This point of maxima. Okay. If f dash of x changes sign from positive to negative, it is a point of maxima. If f dash of x changes sign from negative to positive, it is a point of minima. If f dash of x does not changes its sign, it is point of inflection. Okay. Now here function given, we have to find the points at which local maxima exist, local minima exist and point of inflection. For this simply find f dash of x and equate to 0, and those are called critical points. Okay. How much we got here? What are the critical points here we got? Okay, stationary points we got x equal to 2, minus 1 and 2/7. Okay. Now we will verify the sign of f dash of x. Okay, about a point, how sign is changing. Okay. Now at 2, sign changes from negative to positive. Sign changes from negative to positive, f dash of x changes sign from negative to positive. So it is a point of local minima. So x equal to 2 is point of local minima. Okay. At x equal to minus 1, f dash of x does not changes sign. So it is point of inflection. Okay. Now at x equal to 2/7, okay, around 2/7, f dash of x changes sign from positive to negative. Positive to negative, it is a point of local maxima. Point of local maxima. Okay. Now we will conclude up to here. We will continue remaining problems in next class. Thank you.